Hi, I'm Phyllis from southernfrugal.com. Well, we're in the camper now, and we have been here for 4 days, and we're getting ready to make a green smoothie here, and I'm going to use the Oster blender, which is going to stay up here in Mountain Rest. Now, we've really been initiated into living in a camping trailer, an RV, and it's going to work out okay. It took us a little while to get used to the smallness of everything, but we're able to do it. So anyway, this morning we're going to go ahead and make a green smoothie. We've been having them every morning, and it's a little more difficult because I've got a real small space here, but it's doable. All right, so Mr. Bucky and the dogs are over there on the couch. I don't know if you can see them or not. No, they're on the other end. Anyway, here we go. All right, so this morning's smoothie is going to be the kale, and I've already washed it and put it in my little blender, and we're going to add some strawberries. Now, I'll have to tell you, we have got a store here in Mountain Rest called Ingles, and some of y'all might live close to where you have an Ingles grocery store, but it is fantastic, better than anything we've got in the Columbia, South Carolina area. And so I am very, very happy about that. We bought a chuck roast there and had that day before yesterday. And it was so good, super tender, very tasty. And so we're very, very happy about that. And also we have, you know, kind of gotten used to the smallness of everything. It's kind of a challenge to start with, especially with 3 dogs, but they've gotten used to it too. And to start with, Wheeler, he's the one of the poodles. He decided he didn't like the door of the camper. He didn't like it when you close the door. It made a funny noise to him, and so he was afraid. So every time he went out, we would have to go outside and literally pick him up to bring him in. But now it's been 4 days, and so this morning he's going out and in on his own. So we're very happy with that. And by the way, the Ingles grocery store has a lot of organic. What it reminds me of is a cross between Bilo, Whole Foods Market, and 14 Karat. Mr. Bucky's over there on the couch reminded me. 14 Karat is our organic food, health food store here, or in the Columbia area. Okay, now I'm gonna cut that apple open and just see, because my apples weren't good. It's the time of year. Although that one looks good. I've thrown away about 3 of the apples because it's, you know, way past apple season. And I'm not real interested in, you know, having apples from Argentina or Brazil. So I like to have our produce as much as we can, and our fruit come from this country. Alright, so this apple looks good this morning. Now, the Oster blender does, of course, not do as good a job as the Vitamix does. And maybe at one point we might even actually get a Vitamix for up here. Although Mr. Bucky's shaking his head, so maybe we won't do that. But anyway, the blender works fine. It just doesn't grind the greens up. You'll still be able to see, you know, a few of the greens in there. And also, I wanted to tell you about this. Y'all probably know about this already, but I have never bought, I think they call them blood oranges. They've really got probably a more of a professional name than that, but that's what I've heard them called. And they're actually a navel orange. See that little thing right there? but they're red on the inside and they're very, very sweet. Look at that. Isn't that something they call these, the nickname for them, we'll say, is blood oranges. And I don't remember the real official name for them, but they are very, very sweet. And I just cut around it so I can get some of the pulp out. Now with the oyster blender, we do not get as much in there as we can with the Vitamix. And I kind of push the envelope by cramming a lot of stuff in, so we'll see how this works out this morning. All right, so I'm just going to squeeze my oranges right into the blender here. And a lot of that pulp will come out too. So yeah, we're learning to work in a small space, and it's definitely been a little bit of a challenge with the three dogs in here also. And plus, we weren't able to do as much outside because the first 2 days it rained, and then these last 2 days it's very, very cold. Now, we did bring jackets, and I brought a heavy sweater, but we actually should have brought our down jackets. So Mr. Bucky didn't get to use his chainsaw because it was so cold out there. And he only had a jacket, so you couldn't stand it outside for very long. But anyway, we're planning to come right back next week. Hopefully it will be warmer then. And we'll, you know, get to it. All right, I need to put me some peanut butter in for the extra energy that it'll give us. So we're going to see if I can get that in too. Probably about 4 tablespoons ought to do it. Let me turn the camera up so you can see. There. All right, and now I'm going to use the almond milk. Spoon wiped off. So I brought a lot of spices and, you know, the salt, sugar, and stuff like that that we'll need, sort of the basics. But, of course, I need to bring a lot more stuff, or actually, maybe I can even buy some of it while we're up here, because we do have great shopping up here. All right, so now let's see if we can add some almond milk to this. We can get this going here. All right. So yeah, you learn to make do with what you got. Sorry about the jiggling. Okay, here we go. There it is. And I don't really have any counter space, but you can work on the table that's with the little booth. So I'm gonna start this out on low and get it going. Enough that I could get that peanut butter down. All right, here we go, full speed. Taste, because boy, if that needs sugar, I'm gonna put some in it. Now it's not real super ground up yet. Doesn't need any sugar, it's fine. All right, here we go, full speed now. Pull that out where you can see. And this is the Oster blender, and I do highly recommend these. You know, but when you can afford a Vitamix, that's the one that works best. All right, here we go. definitely takes longer in this blender, but it does do the job okay. Now you can still see some of the little green leaves from the kale in there. It actually looks kind of pretty. All right, we're having to use the smaller cups because I don't have my 20-ounce glasses with me. I'll have to get some of those. Give it a try. Very, very good. All right, so we're going to go ahead and have our smoothies, and I'll record some more when we get in the booth over here, and we'll talk some more about this mountain property. All right, we'll be back in a minute. Okay, we have finished our smoothies. They were very good. Not quite as good as if we had fixed them in the Vitamix, but we can deal with it. And so we've already had our devotions for this morning. Now we're going to leave later on today and go back home, but well, this is home too. But anyway, I wanted to show you what it looks like. We're sitting at the little breakfast nook now. Let me see if you can see the dogs over there. Can y'all see them on the couch? That's Steely down there by himself, and there's Peppy and Wheeler, and they already had their breakfast and have gone out and taken care of their business. But I don't know if you can see out that window. We have got a mountain view, but I'll take it out closer so you can see. But once the leaves are on the trees, I'm not sure we're going to have much of a mountain view then. But anyway, we are definitely up on top of a mountain. And it is super, super quiet up here. We sleep like babies at night. Well, last night we did. For a couple of nights, Steely kept waking up and a couple of times he wanted to go out and that kind of thing. So everything's new to the dogs. But anyway, so I wanted to show you the view outside the window when we're having our breakfast. Yeah, I'm videotaping sort of into the sun, but there's the road that comes in. Anyway, we met our neighbor. Isn't that great? Now, all those pine trees over there just on the other side of that road are going to go, and we're going to plant a whole bunch of fruit trees, apple, and of course persimmon. We're going to definitely have persimmon. But Mr. Buggy just mentioned that, see that crepe myrtle right there, and he's got a long stick up in that tree, or a long trunk of a tree, laying right on the top, and he told us what that meant, the reason he put that there. But we've forgotten. We don't remember what he said. So it's something about the septic tank field or something like that. We're just not sure. But anyway, this is what it looks like in the morning. This is the view we have from our little breakfast nook. And of course, we've got a little patio outside there.
Over here now.
Over there, yeah. I don't know if they can see. The garden area is way out yonder. Let's see if we can see. Yeah. Oh, yeah, we got the little patio where you can sit out there, and the little park benches. That's really nice. So we met the neighbor, one of the neighbors. Well, let me turn this around. We met the neighbors that have the horses right behind us. At Shirley. It was her name, and yeah, Keith. Shirley and Keith. And anyway, very, very nice couple. And they were telling us that that we would really be surprised in the spring and summer, because she has all kinds of perennial flowers all around. And of course, we can see some of them. Some of them are coming up by the walkway there. But we really like the way he has laid out all the driveways coming through here. And he's got gravel on them, so you don't really have to worry about them washing away and that kind of thing. And there are some dogwoods here, dogwood trees, and several very large cedar trees right as you turn in. But anyway, I'm going to let Mr. Bucky talk some, what his impressions are of all of this. Hopefully it'll be positive. So I'm going to turn this around, so hold on. Okay, well, you're on.
Yeah.
Okay, and you can see me too. Hey, I'm back in the mirror. Hey, this is good. Look, yeah, I can record both of us. I'm further away than you are, yeah. But okay, we're ready.
Well, what I was, really talking about this morning was this patio, this outside patio that we
I'm trying to get him to look into the camera when he talks.
But also with this covered area, I mean, it's a covering over the whole camper. And that gives us an awning that we can sit out here.
Yeah. Right out there. We can sit out there even if it's raining.
Yeah,
of course, it was so cold this time we couldn't sit out at all.
Oh, that's true. That's true. It was very cold. But it's nice just the way these driveways work. Real nice. Real nice. I like it.
Yeah. So
I enjoy it a lot.
So I wanted to show about the WD-40. What happened is, of course, no one has lived here for a while. And so some of the locks, I'll show y'all. See those little latches on the doors? That's a closet door and a like a little pantry door. And they kept getting stuck and you couldn't get them open. Yeah. And then the bathroom door got stuck and you couldn't get out. And then the front door got kind of messed up, stuck like that. And we were in and couldn't get out again. So Mr. Bucky went and bought some WD-40, and that's worked like a dream. So
I had to do it too for that, for the propane gas.
Yeah, to be able to get that off. Well, the other thing now, what happened was there was no one living here for a while, and now our black water tank is directly connected to the RV, so we don't have to really use the holding tanks, but Mr. Hughes said that he recommended just using the holding tanks and dump them about every 10 days. But anyway, what we ended up doing, I'll turn it around now because since I'm talking so much. So plumbing is my area and electrical, and Mr. Bucky's is everything else. the carpentry and cars and yard and all that. So I do plumbing, electrical, and cooking and cleaning, and he does all the yard and the cars, the truck. We got a little truck and all that. So anyway, on the plumbing part, let me show you the sink right there. See where these drawers are? Well, you can pull those out, and that's the drain pipes, you know, for the sink and the little trap and everything. Well, the trap apparently had frozen the water because there was no water in the pipes, but the trap apparently had a little water in it, and it froze and kind of cracked the trap under the kitchen sink. And so as soon as we were in here and I cut the water on to wash my hands, I heard it dripping, and I looked, and so we had to go down to Lowe's and, you know, buy a new trap to go in there where it had cracked. But it froze between the time we had already signed the contract, and they had some cold weather up here, and between the time we actually bought it. But, you know, no big deal. It was just a matter of running down and getting the trap part and putting it in. But on the black water tank, we had a little bit of a problem. And I mean, we've never stayed in a camper before. We never have.
No.
And we didn't know how all that worked. But anyway, we have figured it all out now, and it's working well. We don't have any odor or anything coming from in there. It's real good. But we do have a problem, a little bit of a problem, because with all the long hair, you can't really, you don't have enough hot water to take a bath and wash your hair. So what we're going to do is actually build an outside shower. And of course, you'll only be able to use it in the summertime. But have y'all ever seen those before? My cousin had one. This was in the 1950s. And my cousin Jerry built it. He was the oldest grandchild on mother's side. And it was a 55-gallon drum up above. And then you just waited till the sun heated everything up. And he actually had a little shower connection. I think he probably did it for a shop project or something like that. But anyway, me and my cousin Marcia and Diane, I think, was with us too, would go in there and take showers. We thought that was really neat. But anyway, we're going to build something like that, not with a 55-gallon drum, I don't think, but something to do with that and let the sun warm the water up. And so when we're working here in the garden and in the yard and all that, and we get hot, and smelly and dirty, we can take a shower outside, and I'll have enough to wash my hair too. All right, so I'm gonna let Mr. Bucky talk now.
Well, the one thing I want to make sure we talk.
Let me turn the camera around. There we go.
One thing I want to make sure that we tell them is about all these flowers.
Yeah.
I have to get a flower book to be able to identify all of them, because she has got so many flowers planted. They're all already getting very pretty.
Yeah.
But they're going to be great during the summer.
And we got up at the front driveway part there, she's got four huge butterfly bushes.
Right.
And he even put in a little butterfly house.
That's right.
I thought it was for bats. And I was like, oh, I hope that's not a bat house up there. But it's for butterflies. Yeah.
I've never seen one of those before. The two storage buildings are already coming in handy.
Yeah.
You know, we're leaving things there.
Yeah.
And there are so many positives here. The fence, of course, is a great positive. And, of course, the dogs, they've already checked out the entire perimeter of the area.
And they've also checked out the horses.
They've checked out
And the horses have checked them out. Those are beautiful horses out there.
They are.
And Shirley told me that they were very, what did she call it? I'm trying to think of the word. They're easygoing and gentle.
That's gentle.
And she said they're draft horses. Those big, the hooves are just huge.
Oh, yeah. Like the Clydesdale horses.
I really think they're prettier, actually. But
she says
they're bigger than the Clydesdales, even.
They came from France, Keith said.
Yeah.
So that's interesting.
Yeah.
But it's just something. We're just getting used to it. You know, it's. There's so many things to brag about.
Yeah. So the first day, though, we were both thinking, oh, man, this RV trailer is way small. And we really both were thinking the same thing. Because, like, see here in the walkway, you know, only one person. You can't even pass anybody. And by the way, there's a bedroom back there. And, of course, that's the quilt I brought. And all those bags on the bed are dirty clothes and stuff like that were taken back. But in fact, let me just show y'all. I'll show you the bathroom too. And the floor's in really good shape. It only got one little place right there. But every time we see it, we keep thinking it's a bug, you know? Anyway, there's a little sink. And I'm, of course, learning how to cook on the gas stove. But I do like the oven. And see, you can actually broil under the gas there, which will work out great. So you can make toast. And I've got four burners, but I am having to relearn the gas. You know, I've cooked on gas before, but not in many years. My refrigerator is really nice. Now, he put this in. There's the freezer. There's my tea. I always have to have tea. And stuff, eggs, and there's our kale, and I've actually got some carrots in there too. And milk Bucky's stuff for his coffee. But anyway, it's enough room, plenty of room. But let me show you the bathroom. Now, I haven't really done a lot of cleaning in here. But there's the commode, and see, we've got enough shelf area here, and there's the shower. Yeah, it's a great shower. You just don't have enough hot water to do somebody's hair when their hair is long. We got the vent. Now I'm going to have to clean that up there. And, of course, we've got a nice medicine cabinet. Let me see. I can't see what I'm seeing. Here we go. See? Got a nice medicine cabinet there. And, of course, here's the bedroom. Haven't done a very good job of making up the bed. And I'm probably going to take down these curtains. I like the valance up at the top of them, but I'm going to probably take those curtains down because they kind of interfere with raising the shades up and down. And there's the escape door if we need to. And there's a little thing you put in the little vent, you know, to keep the cold air out. Of course, it's just like the bathroom vent, only it doesn't have a fan in it. So that one here are little lights. I super like those too. Yeah, those are the LDC, I think. Anyway, let me go show you the view again. All right, here are the dogs. Are y'all being nice this morning? They've had their breakfast and Steely's already asleep, but all right, let's see. Y'all can see. I don't know if you can see them, but there are mountains back there. And there's our neighbor's old truck. I don't know, that looks like about a 1970 something or other, which really kind of enhances the view, doesn't it? He's taking the motor out of that or something. Oh, there's the horses. There's one of them. They're out there eating. I don't know if y'all can see that or not.
Steely heard his name.
Yeah. So Steely, did Steely wake up? Yeah. Oh, yeah, we got to tell them about the TV. We had to use a small TV, but look how perfectly it fits on that little shelf there. There's all the connections for the dish because you can't have cable up here. All right, so I'm going to let Mr. Bucky tell you about the dish. That was about a 4 or 5 hour deal of them. Well, let me show you the dish. There it is. Can y'all see it? We got one there.
That's one of them. Yeah.
And then one out the back for the, I don't know which is which, but one of them is for the internet and one of them is for TV.
Okay. This is the internet, and that might be a reason why we had a little trouble yesterday with that system that came in, that weather system. But you know, he doesn't have a whole lot of area back there, and that's one thing we're going to need to think about.
You mean because of the trees?
That's right, because of the trees.
Yeah.
That might have contributed to our problem yesterday.
Well, I mean, we had snow.
That's right.
The day before yesterday, we had snow. And here's the thing. We didn't bring our down jackets. You just brought that little bitty flimsy red jacket.
Well,
and I just brought
a
sweater.
Windbreaker. That's all that is.
Yeah.
Really. But the TV is coming good now.
Yeah.
There's no problem with
the
TV.
Yeah, we have TV. And we see all those plug-ins and all those wires. But anyway, the TV works great. Now, the internet and uploading probably ain't going to happen here because even if you're on the internet and you switch, like I like to watch, you know, YouTube videos myself. Yeah. And if I'm watching a video and then I want to switch, you know, maybe I cut it off before it ends and I want to switch to the next one, then it does that, you know, the little thing where it goes around and around. Yeah. What do you call that? Searching or something?
Well, yes.
Buffering.
Sorry.
No, buffering. Buffering, yeah.
Buffering.
All right, so it's your turn to talk.
Well, I don't know, but I almost run out of things to say. But if you, you know, it's just all, it's hard to take it all in.
Yeah, it is.
Take it all in because there's so many advantages that we have. It's enjoyable.
I mean, once we get our house built, it's going to be phenomenal here, really.
And we already have a site picked out for the house.
Yeah.
And that would be real good. Especially with the septic tank, the well already in.
Yeah, and by the way, we got plenty of water.
And it's good water.
Yeah, it's
real
great water. Mixed. You thought the coffee was good?
Oh,
here?
Yeah.
It makes great tea and, you know.
Water.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, we're just flat in the country up on top of a mountain.
That's exactly right.
And we've got country people here too, don't we?
Yeah.
And the guy who put in the dish network thing, I couldn't believe his accent. I was having trouble understanding him sometimes.
Yeah, he was a little bit like mountain folk.
Was that a mountain accent?
Yeah, sort of. Between Clemson and mountain, you know.
Clemson and mountain, yeah. All right, well, I don't know of anything else. Now, I didn't do any other recordings. So, Bucky, you want to talk some? Is that all you got to say?
What else can I say other than I'm really glad to get Steely. I see he's asleep over there. He had a little trouble the first two nights. There's no question about that.
Yeah.
He kept us up.
Yeah.
Yeah. But now all three dogs have adjusted, and we're going to be working on that porch.
Yeah,
he's
going to have to do some more steps. You see, I've got my mop out there. I hadn't even taken it out of the wrapper.
But the banister needs to go up.
Yeah, the banister is not high enough in the steps. One time, you can't really see it from this angle, but on that end, on this lower end here, there's nothing there. And Peppy, his back leg went off of it, but he didn't fall. But I mean, it wouldn't be far to fall, but still. You know. Now, can y'all see those little purple flowers blooming out there? I don't know what those are. I thought to start with they were maybe Johnny Jump-Ups. Then I thought maybe they were wildflowers. but you don't see any wildflowers anywhere else. So that's why I'm thinking those are some of the flowers she planted also.
Oh, yeah. She just got all kinds of flowers planted.
Yeah, she was.
Of course, tell them about the bird.
We got a bird nest.
I think that might be a harbinger.
A bird nest right there in the corner. And we got a male and a female. I think she might be sitting on that nest now. But anyway, it was cold as blazes last night. So anyway, we got to probably call Mr. Hughes and find out what that stick means for sure, because we've forgotten. And
yeah, all he's done is cut a limb there.
Yeah.
Anyway, somewhere.
I love the way he did the driveway. It's curved around. It really makes it so pretty. So yeah, those crepe myrtle will be up and blooming there. I mean, you know, you cut them back so they'll have the real big blooms. We've actually got a dogwood out there, and I'm not sure what kind of tree that little one is they planted. But anyway, the pine trees are going to go, and we're going to get some fruit trees in here. And I think what we're going to do is go ahead and buy some bigger ones so we don't have to wait so many years for them to, produce apples and whatever. And there's Mr.
Nice
Mr.
little
Peppy.
Herb garden now. Nice
yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I would walk out there, but it's way too cold.
Yeah, way too cold.
Yeah, so we're going to leave the furnace on, you know, maybe turn it down to, what, about 60, and then we're going to, leave things on. All right, he's going
to... Come here, Peppy. Yeah. Peppy just wants to come over here and say hello.
Yeah. Hello, Peppy. You want to say hello to everybody? Peppy was right at home up here, wasn't he?
Oh, yeah. He hadn't missed a lick.
Where he goes, the other two dogs go. So Peppy's sort of the leader. Peppy, are you the leader of the pack? Yeah, he is. He's the leader of the pack. All right, y'all. So we're going to get our stuff in the car and go on back. Oh, I wanted to tell you about the list. All right, turn it around. My turn for camera time. All right. So I had to make a list of all the things that I need to get, and it's actually gone into a second page, and I'm sure on the way back in the car there are going to be other things, but things like something you wouldn't even think twice about. I need a fruit bowl for putting, you know, like bananas and stuff for the smoothies. I need a soap dish for the bathroom, even though we are also using the hand soap. I want a little clothesline outside because we'll have to go to the laundromat when we're here, you know, in the beginning. And I don't want to have to dry. I'd like to be able to hang my clothes out to dry. And I didn't bring any freezer containers or any containers to put leftovers in, like even a bowl. Now, I've got a set of dishes. And, of course, we're going to have to bring some tools back and that kind of thing. So... And we also need a compass because we want to be able to tell, you know, when you're going to do the solar, you need your the roof on the house we're going to build facing a certain way, southeast so many degrees. And you can look it up on the internet and find out where you live, what that exactly needs to be. So we want to get a little more informed on where the house needs to be and the trees that need to go and that kind of thing. So I thought I had thought of everything because I had all kinds of stuff we brought up here, but
you got about 20 different things there
that I need to, like a potato masher, you know, so you have mashed potatoes. And I want to get some of the polish, I don't have many cabinets, but they are wood, and I wanted to, you know, get some of that orange glow to polish them. And I needed an old toothbrush, you know, when you're cleaning to get in little cracks. I needed an old toothbrush, which I didn't have. And we need a whistle for the dogs.
Yes.
Because on 2 acres at night when they go out, you can't see them, even though we've got a security streetlight type thing on one side. If they go all the way out to the fence, you can't see them for anything. So you have to, you know, you're calling and you're having to really holler so they can hear you. And so we're going to get some kind of little whistle and train them to that, so when it's time to come in at night, we don't lose them in the dark, you know. All right, so y'all want to say goodbye. Uh-oh, there's the other two now. So y'all want to tell everybody what y'all think of the mountain property?
Here's
Wheeler. There's a Wheeler. Yeah, Wheeler had a problem adjusting to the door. He just didn't like the door for some reason. Now, Steely, he just had a little trouble sleeping, and that might have been to do with the altitude we're at now. And but Peppy didn't have any problem with anything. Peppy, are you the pack leader? Huh?
I have to show those dogs what to do.
He does, and they follow him. Wherever he goes, they follow him around the yard. But we're ready to go back home now. So anyway, we will see y'all next time. We'll probably be doing a green smoothie tomorrow morning. I'm going to try to cook something, tomorrow and make a video of it, hopefully. All right. This is Phyllis signing off now, and we will see y'all next time. Wrong way, man.